This is what Hannibal sees when he steps inside the frescoed walls of his own mind.
Do you feel closer to him here?
Well, this isn't Hannibal. It's just where he begins. Beyond this, far and complex, light and dark, is the vast structure of his mind. Thousands of rooms, miles of corridors, everything he remembers. Wonderfully and fearfully reconstructed.
Why fearfully?
Hannibal's well-armed against the physical world, but there are places within himself he can't safely go. But we can. If we find them. And that's how we'll find him.
It's the end of an era.
It's the end of something. I probably should have taken compassionate leave while I still had the choice.
Compassionate leave?
His wife.
And she's still sick? I knew she was sick before. I didn't know she was still sick.
It's a terminal situation.
I didn't know that. Well, nobody told me that. Why didn't you tell me that?
Because it's not to be discussed.
Oh, clearly. So, not to be discussed with me.
I was trying to be discreet, Jim.
Since when?
Okay.
I'm so sorry, Jack. So now it's awkward. I mean,
what are you supposed to do with it? I'm sorry.
Oh, this is why no one tells me anything. Don't talk to me.
Gentlemen. Am I interrupting?
Oh, yes, please.
Good news and bad news. The good news is, until recently, a full face transplant was almost unthinkable. But medical science is a fast moving train. First, I'll lift your pretty mush right off. Then I'll expose the blood vessels and major connections of Mason's face. Then lay yours straight on top. You really are done, you know. That's the bad news.
It's big, isn't it? How many rooms?
14.
It's old. Things in here are old.
Martini.
Let me make it.
Thank you.
Mr. Dollarhide, wouldn't you like to bring me your grandmother's teeth?
Just drop the lid.
Thank you.